No, don't need anything yet. Okay. Oh, my mouthpiece is working now too, Todd. Okay. Okay. All right. How about now? Can you hear me now?
For us.
Can you hear me, Mr. Todd?
I can hear you.
Yes, yeah. I can hear you right now. Okay, cool. He's messing with my settings. All right. Damn. That took forever. Oh, my God. I figured out he was messing with the settings, man. All right. I like this thing. Good feel good. It's some good feel good right here. Because we're talking about pain. Pain and suffering. That's what we're talking about tonight. Constipation, because that's what that is, right? I can't hear you, Todd. Talk to me, Mr. Todd. Now I got mine working. Yours ain't.
Good, right back to me now?
Okay, you breaking up, but you're trying to come
through. Can you hear me?
It's trying to come through. It's trying to come through. Oh, let me turn this on. All right. Say something, Todd.
Can you hear me clear?
I can hear you now. All right, what are we talking about today?
Constipation.
Woo! What's that? I don't know what that is.
That's when your bowels are working properly.
Okay, I know I haven't experienced that because I think everybody experienced that. Damn. That's how they feel when they be hurt so bad, they be stuck. Be like, you ever been so constipated that it was a plug and that no matter what you do, you couldn't get it out?
You know, I've seen that happen to babies before. And mothers have to put Vaseline and try to massage them out. Yeah, I've seen that.
It happens to people that's on medication too. If you're in the hospital for an extended period of time and they got you a lot of meds, I've seen it happen to people like that. I mean, it turned into a rock in your stomach, bro. In your intestine lining, it turns into a rock. And even their medication won't push it out. Now, herbs will push it out. Herbs are amazing, first and foremost. I gotta give some props to herbs because I've experienced that, and it took herbs to get it out. I couldn't even dig it out with my hand. That's how bad it was. That's kind of bad, huh? That don't even sound good.
Maybe your fingers are too soft.
Don't choke me, bro. No, first of all, it was gross. Second of all, how can you call it gross coming out your old self, right? It was a rock, man. It was a rock. And it was from they put me on some medication and ain't admit it, but they put me on some medication. I said, I'd never do that again as long as I live. And I grew from there. I just do herb now. Even when they try to give me medication, I take the herb. I ain't doing no medication. So now, what's the deal with constipation then?
Okay, I guess you better introduce yourself first to know who they're talking to.
Okay, well, they on this channel, they already know you're talking to the herbalist. My name is Forrest Gump. I'm an herbalist.
And I'm Todd Lino. So
all right.
Constipation now.
Constipation.
So I guess the first thing that we have to talk about is how do you know if you're constipated?
Well, that's easy. You can't shit. Or it hurts. Or, you know, you're only going, you're eating three meals, but you ain't releasing but one. That's constipation, pimp. Houston, we got a problem.
Okay, but when you go to the doctor, they don't tell you you're constipated because you're only going once. So for example, most people are constipated and don't even know they're constipated. So, you know, that's what the number one problem is. They don't know that they don't address it until it gets so bad that it becomes a medical issue.
Yeah, but people know when they're constipated, Todd.
Okay, I'm going to prove that they don't.
Okay, prove that.
We had a customer who was eating three meals a day.
Okay.
Going to the bathroom once a week. And she didn't know she was constipated.
Right. So she didn't know she was constipated?
She thought that was normal.
Hold on. Say it again. She was
eating 3 meals a day.
So okay.
21 meals a day, and she was going to the bathroom once a week.
21 meals a week, and was only going to the bathroom once a week. She wasn't just constipated. She was a walking toilet, dude. She was a walking sewer system. She wasn't just constipated. The numbers have to make sense. If the numbers don't make sense, then you're constipated. If you eat 3 meals, you're supposed to release all 3 meals.
Yeah, if you eat 3 meals,
go ahead.
If you eat that,
I would say, because if you eat 3 meals and you don't take out but one, Houston, the rocket, everything done blowed up. Because that's not, there's nothing normal, there's no normalcy about that, right?
Well, it's not normal from a health perspective, but from the person who's dealing with this type of stuff situation, it's normal to them because it's been going on for so long. A lot of people only go to the bathroom every other day, maybe 3 or 4 times a week, you know, so that becomes
that don't make normal. No, that ain't normal. No, let's don't call something that ain't normal. How about that? Because you tell people that just because they're used to it, it's normal for them, doesn't mean it's normal. They're just messed up and it didn't be fixed. That's all. That ain't normal.
Okay. I stand corrected. It's not the new normal. It's them being messed up. Okay.
Okay. But there's an easy fix for that. So you're not totally messed up. You just don't know that you're constipated probably, and then you don't know that there's a simple solution for it. What you're eating is not conducive to your system. You only get constipated. You get constipated because of a couple of reasons. I think you're mineral deficient, first of all, I think, and you don't have enough enzymes. So if your food got no enzymes, it's not going to keep moving. If your food, because it's not food, right? Food has enzymes. Everything else that don't have enzymes ain't food. Well, maybe that's the problem, Todd. People don't know what food is.
So are you trying to say that people are not eating food?
Oh, no. Hands down, they are not eating food.
So if they're not eating food, what are they eating then?
Shit. I didn't just make that up. I just stated a fact. Now, what do I mean? Okay. If anything is cooked over 118 degrees Fahrenheit, it's dead. If something is dead, can you get life from it? Yes or no?
No, you can't.
Okay, and pose another question. If what you're eating doesn't sustain life, can you get life from it?
No.
Okay, it's got to make sense now. If it don't make sense, don't make dollars.
But you're asking questions that the average person doesn't think about. So.
Well, why? Okay, start right there. It don't mean that what I'm saying isn't the answer. Right. Okay, so let's stick. First of all, we're going to stick to the facts of what right is, because right works and wrong doesn't, or life works and death doesn't. Because you're trying to stay alive, right?
Yes, the people are trying to stay alive. That's the goal.
Okay, so then this is only about one thing, what works and what doesn't. Because no one in their right mind wants to be constipated, right or wrong.
That's correct.
Then, now, if I'm telling you, if you eat anything cooked over 118 degrees Fahrenheit, it's dead already. In essence, you're eating shit. Because it's already dead. I don't care if the shit tastes good. You're still eating shit because it doesn't give you life. And it doesn't sustain your life. And when it's already dead, it's causing the constipation. So that's too many ands to try to stay alive. That's too many ands to get rid of constipation. Because I just named it. So if you got that, death is the first ingredient to constipation. So if you're eating something that is already dead, then, of course, all thing is left is constipation. Your body can't process it. Your body can't digest it. So it backs up. And like you said, If that's the norm, if eating 21 meals a week and only going once a week is the norm, then the norm is toe all the way up. The norm ain't good. The norm is killing you. And so now you got to get that death out of you. Good thing we have a solution for that. But let's go back to the argument of what constipation is, you know, and then we'll figure out how to at least figure out how to fix it. But first of all, we got to discover it in order to know how to stop it. Does that make sense?
Okay, so let's just as a general rule, let's just say if you're eating three meals a day, you should be having at least two bowel movements a day. If you're having less than two bowel movements a day, then that's going to classify that as constipated. That's not what the doctor is going to tell you, but that's what we're going to use as our common sense metric.
Now, they have that. That's what we're going to tell you. If you ain't going, you're eating three meals a day and you ain't going twice, then you are constipated. I don't care what nobody else tell you. And if you don't change it, the plumbing is going to back up and it's going to cause other problems because of the toxic level in your body. Is that right, Doc?
That's correct.
Then let's don't beat around the bush. Let's tell people like it is, how they can fix it, you know, what the problem is, you know, what's causing it, so they can fix it. Let's don't beat around the bush. Next.
Okay. Everybody knows that you should not be eating. Everybody knows that cheese constipates you and dairy products constipate you. So those are things that you should not be eating.
Do they know that?
Yeah, people know that.
Okay. What about that lady that just said, I ain't giving my cheese for you, niggas? You crazy? She just said, you have lost all your rabbit mind. Okay. I left some words out, but you got the gist. Hold on. I can't hear you. You broke up. Say it again.
I'm just telling her that she needs to deal with the consequences if she doesn't. She has free will. She can eat whatever she wants.
Okay, so you basically said she can tell you what she wants, but she's going to pay for it. That what you said?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Okay, so for those who don't want to change it, keep doing what you're doing, you'll keep having what you have. But for those who do want to change it, what would you say are the number five things that causes constipation?
Number one is what's your diet. That's the
one. Okay, you're breaking up. You're in a bad spot. So
number one is diet.
Okay, now that's kind of generalization there.
Right, so what you're eating is number one. So okay. Number two is not drinking enough water.
Okay.
Number three, I would say, is pharmaceutical drugs like...
Okay, that makes sense. Any medications. Medications can be constipating. Okay.
Lack of exercise, number four.
Okay.
And... let's just go with four. Those are the four main reasons.
Okay, four main reasons. So lack of exercise, not drinking enough liquids, medication, and diet.
Correct.
Okay, so now, what do you think out of all those, what's the number one thing people do every day? Of all of those four?
They eat.
Okay. So then we can deduce that your diet is going to be the main reason why you're constipated. Now, if you're not prepared to change your diet, I don't think I'm even talking to you. See, because if you have this constipation problem, you have to change your diet because that's what's causing it for the most part. You remember the other factors, but we're going to stick with the main factor, which we believe to be is diet. I also believe a lack of minerals and nutrients and or enzymes can be a cause of that because your body needs those enzymes to digest. That's why we have a formula called digestive enzymes. You see how that went together? Your body needs enzymes to digest, so we made a formula called digestive enzymes. That's pretty good. All right, anyway, I'm tooting my own horn right now. but since your food has no enzymes, that means you got to get them from a secondary source. Which is actually the best source because guess what? Herbs are food.
Right.
That's right. Herbs are food. So now you still need food with enzymes no matter how you play it. So if you got to take if you're going to eat your poison and you got to get enzymes, you might as well take my digestive enzymes with the dead food you're going to eat. That's for those who's not going to change their diet. But if you're going to change your diet and have a 70-30 ratio, 70% green with enzymes and 30% none, then you'll probably fix that digestive problem anyway. But for those who won't, you know, I recommend the herbs, because even I take the herbs. Because they're not just good for digestive enzymes. They're good for acid reflux. They're good for many, many different things when it comes to consuming food that will cause you problems. So now, your diet is bad. What are you going to do about it?
So, okay, so you have to get going to a more... First of all, you're eating things that don't have enough fiber in it. There's no fiber in meat. So... you have to eat things that like fruits and vegetables have fiber, which is going to help you sweep your colon out, and so that you will be able to move, so you won't be constipated.
Okay. So eat stuff with more fiber. Eat fruits and vegetables that have more enzymes. Okay. So now we didn't say go raw, did we?
We didn't say go raw, but raw is better.
Okay. So. If you can, add more raw food to your diet. And that's going to also help you, because remember that raw food is alive food. And dead food is what's constipating you, but raw food won't constipate you. So add more raw food to your diet. Now, 9 out of 10 people who heard them words ain't going to do that. You know that, right?
Yeah, I understand that. Like I said, there's consequences to not doing this. So let me just explain some to people. Now, do you think most people believe that, well, most people are pretty clean as far as hygiene. Don't you think most people are pretty clean as hygiene?
Don't make me lie. I don't think most people are clean when it comes to hygiene.
Okay, so let me ask you this a different way.
Okay, okay.
Most people think that they are clean as far as hygiene from showering and, you know, whatever they're doing.
Okay, I'll give you that one. Okay, yeah, I'll say yeah to that.
But they're only cleaning the outside of their body. When do they clean the inside of their body?
I like that. You said something.
So the inside of your body, your colon, your intestinal tract is filthy. So if you're preoccupied with showering 2 and 3 times a day, most people I know take a shower or bath at least once a day. Why aren't you cleaning your internal self, your colon out at least once a month?
Because nobody's told them they need to do it. Remember, there is no manual on the human body and how to sustain it.
Okay, so let me ask you another way. When people go when people sit on the toilet and they use the bathroom, who told them to use toilet paper and wipe their butt?
Their
somebody
parents
told them that at some point.
Their parents.
So you're wiping your anus, but there's still a lot of feces all up and down your colon and your intestinal tract.
But I can't see that.
But it doesn't mean it's not there.
But I still can't see it. And guess what? The odor is closed off. It's internal, so I can't see it. I can't feel it. It's closed off. I don't know how much residue built up, whatever you want to call it.
What do you mean that's closed off? There's an opening.
No, that opening closes, Joker. Wait, once I empty out what's at the doorway, that opening closes up. When it closes up, guess what? Odor be gone. And I use the toilet paper.
They're not passing gas while they're walking around.
That opening. But they walk away from that cloud. So when they pass the gas and that cloud hit them, they walk away from that cloud. They happy at that point, so they don't care after the fact. I'm not checking my intestines going, let me see if I got some residue in my... Hell, I can't see my liver, my lung, my kidneys either. I ain't worried about them. So why am I going to worry about whether my intestines' internal side is dirty? All I want to do is make sure I can get what's at the doorway out so I can feel a little bit better, remember?
Wash your car, wash the inside and the outside of it. You don't just worry about the outside.
I'm gonna watch the outside, but I ain't watching the inside because I can't see it. So I can have a line of doo doo built up on my internal side as long as I can't see it. I'm okay. See, okay, and as long as you can't smell it,
it's better. See, here's the thing: having shit on your lips is okay because it can't hurt you. But having shit inside of you is harmful.
Well, yeah, but of course it's harmful, but ain't nobody teaching me how to clean that inside. I was just taught to make sure I don't get no streaks on the outside.
Okay. So we have to do, so we have to teach them a new thing. You have to clean yourself internally as well. The reason that it's important is because most diseases begin in the colon. So when you're eating, you know, rare steak and all these other things, you have to understand that you don't have the intestinal digestive juices strong enough to kill everything in that meat. So you're going to have parasites that are going to be hatching and growing and all up and down your system.
Okay, so I can't see how dirty I'm in, so I need to clean my insides. Is that going to help me with my constipation?
Yes, it will help you with your constipation, because once you start using stuff, herbs like psyllium husks and centipods and leaves, you're gonna push everything out. See, okay, I'm giving you an example. When John Wayne was they did an autopsy on John Wayne, he had 70 pounds of feces in his intestinal tract. 70 pounds. You know what 70 pounds of shit is?
That's a lot of doo-doo.
That's a lot. I mean, that's a pile.
Dang. You know, people can visually see that. You know that, right?
Yeah. So you got to think about this. Now, you know what a 2-pound steak looks like? Just imagine a 70 pounds of something just sitting on the side of the road. And that's what's in your, say you got 20, 30 pounds of it sitting inside your colon. And you're a man and you're walking around wondering why you look like you're pregnant. It's because your intestines are full of waste products and they've been expanding. You're eating 3 meals a day, going to the bathroom once a week. Where do you think all that food is going?
So is it safe to say men who have bulging stomachs just got a whole bunch of waste? I mean, honestly, there's some fat there somewhere, but for the most part.
There's fat, and there's also that your intestines have been expanding because they're holding all this feces.
Man.
This is why when you go in surgery, they're wearing masks. When they cut you open, you smell like a damn sewer.
Now we know why they wear masks, huh?
Yeah.
Damn. Constipation ain't no joke. Okay, so what's the solution?
Okay. So the solution, number one, is you need to be taking a colon cleanse at least once every 6 months. You're eating every day. I'm not expecting you to clean yourself out every day, but at least once every 6 months, you need to be doing some type of colon cleanse with some herbs that's going to push all this waste out of you. Like, just like has a janitor to sweep. You know, you don't, even in your house, you do a spring cleaning every season. Sweep the floor. Get that stuff out of you.
Okay, wait. Now, why herbs though? Why I can just do a liquid cleanse, right? Why herbs?
You can do a liquid cleanse. Now, okay, the reason I say you're going to use something like psyllium husk is because a liquid cleanse, say you're drinking water or something that's in liquid, it's going to rinse. Okay, sometimes you know, rinsing something off doesn't always get it out because you don't have enough pressure. It's not like you're pressure washing this rinse out. So you need something that's going to actually bulk up and sweep, because you got to remember, a lot of the stuff that's in your system has been there for 5 years. So you have like your feces, when you start doing a colon cleanse, you'll see different colors. You'll see black, like a tire. That means it's been in your system so long, it's putrefied. It's been in there like maybe, you know, more than, not just months. It's been in there for a long time. You'll see different balls. It means that the balls, it means it's been lodged in your intestinal walls. It's been sitting there. So when you take a psyllium husk and centipods, you'll see this stuff being pushed out. It'll loosen it up and it'll push it out.
Well, and the reason, I'm going to add to that, because the reason I think you should do herbs as opposed to just a liquid, liquids don't give back. For example, liquids will do just that. They'll try to flush, but you don't get a benefit from liquid. There are no minerals and nutrients from the liquid flush. From the herbal flush, you're getting the sweeping effect, but you're also getting the minerals and nutrients that are in those herbs to enhance the body's ability to do just what it's designed to do. So I think there's a twofold effect when you choose herbs as opposed to any kind of liquids, anything. I don't care what it is you're doing. You need the minerals and nutrients, and then the coarseness of the plants themselves also has a job function to do. So when you was talking about the sweeping and things of that nature, that makes sense to me. So I
And
recommend
also,
herbs.
there's another thing too, is that your intestinal walls have this little hair-like substance called villi, which actually absorbs the nutrients when you eat food. But when those villi are covered in feces, because your intestinal walls are just so compromised, you can't even absorb any nutrients from the food you're eating, no matter what you're eating, no matter how good you're eating.
People don't know that, man. Hold on. You know, if they don't know, they need to wipe, clean the insides, just the intestinal walls. They don't know what the villi is and its true function. The above average person don't know that. So you're speaking a foreign language, even though you're telling the truth and you're educating. You know, to me, you're speaking a foreign language,
Right.
especially if you
Okay,
go to
I
level.
understand that. I understand that, but let's just keep it simple. You're eating food and it's passing through your body and you're not absorbing any nutrients because your colon is covered with feces. That's all you need to know. Forget about the villi and all that. Just know that you're not absorbing any nutrients because you're So that speaks to the level of now you have issues with vitamin, I mean mineral deficiency, because you're not even if you have the minerals in your diet, you're not getting them because you're not absorbing them. Now, other things that are bad is because you have this stuff in this cold, you have these things in your body for this food, I mean this waste in your body for so long, it's toxic, number one. But number two, you know, you're especially in our community, the African American community, we eat a lot of barbecued meats. And it tells you on the bottle that that's poison. Anybody who doesn't know that, look at your lighter fluid. It tells you if you ingest that, they don't say go to the doctor. They say go to a poison control center. So you're squirting lighter fluid on your food, on your meat, on the coals. The vapor of it is coming up on the food, saturating, because you want to have that lighter fluid taste in your mouth when you eat the meat, or it's not good. And guess what? That's a cancer. That's a cancer-causing substance. That's why so many African Americans end up with colon cancer after years of eating so much barbecue.
Dang, dang, dang.
Now, I'm not trying to take your barbecue from you. I'm not trying to tell you to take your barbecue. But what I'm telling you is, if you do a colon cleanse periodically, you can limit the damage and the likelihood that you could have these colon cancer and have to have your colon cut out and part of your colon snipped because you've been misusing your body.
That's why you constipated. Damn, damn, damn. Constipation ain't no joke. Okay, so. All right, so we now know your diet is toe up. I'm gonna say I don't believe 90% of people hearing this is gonna change their diet. So I'm gonna say, as you said, get yourself some herbs to at least offset the damage. Your plumbing is everything. If your body become toxic, you will get sick. It's that simple.
And I'm gonna give them one last thing. You should be looking in the toilet when you use the bathroom. Now, there's some things you should be looking for. First of all, you want to make sure there's no worms in there.
I don't want to look at my shit. What am I looking at my shit for?
Because you need to be checking to make sure everything's okay. You want to make sure there's no blood in your stool. You want to make sure there's no worms. But what you also should be looking for, you should be making sure your feces is floating. If it's sinking to the bottom of your toilet, that means you're eating incorrectly.
Well, then
And that means that you.
that's 90% of the people listening. This shit sinking.
So
It ain't floating.
the reason it's not floating is because when you eat a lot of fruits and vegetables, it puts air bubbles in the feces and it makes it float. So that's why it's floating like that. So when it's sinking, it
Ooh-wee.
means that you're not eating improper. And now, and also, when you go to the bathroom, it's not supposed to have a foul odor.
Come
A
on, man.
foul
You're
odor.
going. Hey, buddy, you're
A
going too
foul
far.
odor. A
You're going
foul
too far,
odor means
buddy.
a foul odor means something is rotten in you. You've eaten some raw eggs and they've rotted inside of you, and now you smell that rotten egg and you feel that you smell that
Okay, buddy.
decomposing.
Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy. You're going too far. You're going too far, buddy. Okay? Stop it, I say. You can't call me steak, buddy. You're going too far, okay?
But I mean, I'm just being honest. You have to understand that if you leave a raw egg out, it's going to, what is it going to start smelling? So if you cook, eat a raw egg and you leave it in your body for 2 months, it's going to start smelling. So that's why your feces smells like that, because you're eating foods that's decomposing and rotting on your body. So you don't
Well, people don't realize, if you just listen to some of the words, a chicken is called a what?
Fowl.
What does the word foul mean?
He's out of bounds.
Foul means funky, putrefied. He said out of bounds. I'm going to say what it really means. You know, foul is not good. So the chicken foul is definitely not good, because it's GMO. It ain't natural anymore. It's GMO. Now that odor, and you know this too, because it smells bad before you cook it. It smells bad before you cook it. So you know it's foul. If you look up the word foul, you're going to get more than one meaning. And you're going to discover the one you're getting every time you eat chicken. You're getting, you know, it's foul. It's very vulgar. It's foul. Okay, so in any case, I had to add that to that, because we're talking about staying alive. We're talking about getting rid of constipation. We're talking about a solution to it. Got to change your diet. You got to put the minerals and nutrients back. What else, Todd?
So, okay, let's say, I do understand everybody's not going to make all these changes. So I
like, no, they're also not.
I like to also give things they can do. So, for example, let's say you continue to eat a bad diet. If you don't want your bowel movements to smell like that, you can take activated charcoal. That will
absorb that odor. And it will not hurt you. Let me say that again. It will not hurt. It will not harm you. People seem to think that activated charcoal, if you consume it, it's going to harm you. You know, if I thought that it was going to harm me, at least I would do the research to see if it would. I'm telling you right now, you can put a quarter of a teaspoon of activated charcoal in your water and drink it, and it will not harm you at all. As a matter of fact, it'll push the toxins out of your body from the toxic diet that you're consuming. It'll neutralize the toxicity in your body. Go ahead, John.
So are we talking about charcoal briquettes? Activated charcoal? That's what you're talking about?
No, Negro. Ain't nobody said about no briquettes. That's a French word, briquettes. I said activated charcoal. I ain't say nothing about no briquette. Okay? Don't be adding words to me.
Okay, so food-based charcoal is burnt. What is that? Burnt coconut shells.
Coconut shell. Yellow bark. It's plant-based, food-based charcoal.
Yeah. Okay.
So you do have to check them. By the way, you do. Don't go get no briquettes, because that's liable to kill you. So be careful. Don't listen to this crazy man. I said activated charcoal, food grade, you know. It's on my website, so you can't go wrong. I'm not going to sell you no briquettes, okay? It ain't going to help. Go ahead, Todd.
Okay, so some of the formulas that we have on the website is the colon formula.
Okay.
There's the intestinal janitor, and then there's, okay. What's the other one?
A synfin.
Synfin, yeah. Those are the three synfin that you want to get. And the difference, I personally like the colon form. It's more balanced. It has some activated charcoal in there. It has some black walnut hulls in there, so they kill parasites. There are stronger forms. If you're really stocked up, you want to get like the intestinal janitor, or you want to get the
synfin. You blow the back of the wall off, messing with that synfin. Be careful though. My intestinal janitor is bowel mover. Bowel mover. There's three levels. There's a colon, bowel mover, and then synfin. The synfin is by far the strongest. The colon is the mildest. So right there in the middle is the bowel mover, which used to be our intestinal janitor. That will definitely get you going. So I would start there, but I would also get activated charcoal, because you want to neutralize the toxins in your body no matter what. You know, just moving your bowels and eating, you know, is not going to do that. So add the activated charcoal, and that just enhances the body's ability to heal. Go ahead.
Now, also, women that are pregnant, the reason that you're becoming constipated is because the doctor is recommending or prescribing an iron formula. He's actually prescribing an inorganic iron formula called iron phorosis. That, what that does is it dries up your intestines, and that's why you suffer from constipation. So you don't want to take an inorganic iron supplement. You want to take a plant-based iron supplement. So something like this going to have yellow dock or burdock root in this. It's going to give you a natural plant-based source of iron.
And to add to that, you want complete plant, especially if you're pregnant women, you want complete plant-based minerals and nutrients for your pregnancy, which we call prenatal laxative. We have stuff that's plant-based that's going to deliver all the minerals and nutrients you need, natural minerals and nutrients, organic minerals and nutrients, not that synthetic stuff, because your body can't use it. It's going to try, but it can't, and it will cause you a problem, like you just said. Okay, so I digressed a little bit, but go ahead, Tom.
So I guess give me your website so they know where to get the stuff at.
www, all the W's you want. TheUrbanHerb.net or www.herbsoftheforest.com. You can reach that one number is 888-619-4372. You can call us anytime and ask us questions no matter what. You know, we're going to be straight and honest with you. You know, not to just say anything, but to help you. So please feel free to give us a call. Share this podcast if you don't mind. Somebody you know that might be constipated, somebody you know that might be really, 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 really stank inside. You know, they farting around you or something. Share this podcast with you. And stay tuned for the next topic because, you know, we know you're going to like it because it's all about helping you. What say you, sir?
Thank you for listening. You guys have a nice day.
Awesome. Until next time. Peace out.